我发觉咧，原来好多人对伊朗咧都系唔系好认识，而且充满好奇嘅。例如会问：咦，系咪旅客都要戴头巾嘅咧？嗰度啲女人系咪全部都黑布蒙头嘅咧？其实戴头巾咧，的确系伊朗当地嘅法律规定嚟嘅。只要你是一个女性啦，而你进入到伊朗境内的话呢，你就一定要是戴头巾的啦。但是小朋友就不用的，只是过了青春期的女性才要的啫。至于要不要黑布蒙头呢，其实都是好看他们个人的选择啦，同埋好看场合的。好似而家咁，我哋去到呢个 Holy Shrine 啦，系一个拜祭嘅地方。咁你就会见到咧，周围嘅妇女咧都系会全身咧着晒长多嘅，即系呢个黑色嘅罩啦。咁就净系突翻块面同埋双手出嚟嘅啫。题外话啦，大家见到好多洞喺度嘅牌咧，上面有啲男性嘅样子啦。其实咧呢啲咁样嘅牌咧，可能喺好多嘅清真寺啦，同埋好多嘅街道上面都会见到嘅。咁佢哋就唔系做紧啲咩个人或者系一啲父权嘅崇拜啦，而系咧上面其实系喺两伊战争丧生嘅军人嚟嘅。咁佢哋就洞喺度纪念翻佢哋咁样咯。
而家嚟到一间嘅庙啦，咁就要着翻呢一啲嘅衫包翻个身，有200岁噶啦呢间庙。
当地嘅女性喺进入呢啲拜祭嘅地方嘅时候咧，通常都会着晒全身嘅 cover 啦。咁而呢啲纸嘅门口咧，都会为我哋呢啲游客提供呢啲嘅衣着嘅。不过咧，一般喺街咧，其实好多女性都唔系黑布蒙头嘅，佢哋甚至咧系着得好时尚嘅添。而且佢哋嘅衣着保守与否咧，其实都好睇佢哋本身嘅家庭啦，同埋佢哋嚟自嘅城市嘅。例如我哋去到 Isfahan 咧，就会见到有啲女生咧系染晒发啦，然后咧啲头发基本上咧系飞晒出嚟，求其笠个头巾嘅啫。但系去到 Kashan 咧，又会见到啲女生咧系包得密实好多嘅，甚至街上面都会有好多黑衣人。咁我亦都梗系要问下当地嘅朋友点睇女性戴头巾呢样嘢啦。
点解男人唔使戴呢啲巾先？睇佢有咩讲。
One religious subject. Covering for women is important.
Cover
for women is more important in Islamic religion. For example, if we use just some clothes is enough for women, for men, but women should cover every parts of body, just face and hand. It's one Islamic subject. If you stay here, come here.
Wow. Okay. Thank you.
Can we ask you some very sensitive questions?
Of course, we know.
What do you like? We've heard that there's a lawyer, Iranian lawyer, who fights for the headscarf laws in Iran, and she's now jailed. So, what do you think about the laws here regarding the headscarf?
No, if you ask it of some younger people like me, for example, or.My friend or something like this. Of course, you know, they are not unlike, or for example, I mean, opposite of the job, but they don't like to have, I mean, a so serious hijab like some, I mean, religious people or something like that. You see the black chador or something like that?
Yeah.
Just we don't like to use them.
Okay.
We want, like, I mean, for example, be like this style, but...Yeah. Unfortunately, most of the religious people, they don't like us.
Oh, so the religious people don't like you dressing like this.
Yes,
they want you to wear the very black one. Okay, okay. Okay. So is there, like, there are protests? That there's some woman just take off the headscarf in public?
Yes, last year we had.
Oh, okay.
But actually, some police, they went to catch her.
Okay.
We have a lot of problems, especially in Tehran.
Oh, in Tehran.
Because it's the capital.
Okay.
And actually, it's more modern than other cities.
Okay.
It's so bigger, it's so busy, so crowded.
Okay.
And the culture of Tehran is exactly different than other parts of Iran because the people are more open-minded then.
So, like, the ones who are more religious are, like, older people?
They are more religious.
Hmm.
Me and some friends like me, we believe Islam is not the opposite of beauty. You can have a nice hijab, but with, I mean, the colorful, I mean, dress, or with a good style. You don't have to, I mean, use the chador or something like this.
Mm.
But unfortunately, some religious people said no, it's not acceptable.
You need to be very modest.
That's right.
And, like, not showing your beauty,
right,
not showing your curves.
That's right, they believe that.
Okay. So, like, there are different levels of being religious.
That's right.
But is it that basically everyone in Iran is Muslim? Basically?
Everyone are Muslim, yes,
okay.
In Iran. But, for example, in some parts of Tehran, some of them are Christian, but it's not so common. For example,
okay.
they were born in another country or
okay.
something like that.
Do you know about the human rights lawyer being jailed? Put into prison?
Yes.
For 30 years?
No, I don't know about that.
You don't know?
No.
Whipped, you know, for 100 times?
Yes.
So it's in international news? And then I wonder, like, how local people will think about this, because maybe some religious people will think that this is the right punishment.
That's right.
But I think maybe some people still think that it's not right, it's very unfair.
That's right, it's unfair.
Hmm.
Hi. Now I think it's a bad situation in Iran, but I don't know what will happen in 2020. Think about, for example, my city.
Okay.
That's if you can, there 10 years ago, 100% of women they use, I mean, they wear black chador or something like this.
No chador.
But now after 10 years, just maybe 30% of them.
除了衣着之外，其实他们的日常生活都充满着性别色彩，对男女的分野是非常之明确的，就好像这个敲门用的门环一样，每家每户的门口基本上都是有的，男人就要用这个好像一支嘢这样去敲门，女人就要用好像这个窿这样去敲门。
Actually, the people inside could understand now who is outside. Is it men or women?
The sound is different.
Yes,
boom, boom.
Oh, okay.
And because of that, actually, the people inside could understand now who is outside. Is it men or women? If, for example, we understand the outside is a man, we should use a scarf.
而在机场过安检的时候，男人和女人都是分开了两条不同的通道的，而女性的通道就只会有女性的关员，因为有可能会因为安全的关系要女性除下头巾，或者要摸她的身去检查有没有带些违法的东西，所以只会有女性关员。下一集我可能或者应该会同大家分享下我在沙漠的浪漫之旅。至于在伊朗遇到的性别反思，我可能迟下都会 update 上去 IG 同埋我的 gender blog 嗰度啦。如果大家中意睇嘅，记住 subscribe 我 YouTube 啦 ，follow 我 IG，follow 我 Patreon，follow 我 Facebook。下次见啦，拜拜。